Hey Cafe Crew, it's Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe, and today I'm going to show you how to apply a cinematic color grade to your photographs to give them a little bit of flavor. So what I'm doing here is I'm using two photographs that I got from Adobe Stock, which is a great place to get photos from. Also, be aware you can sell your photos on Adobe Stock as well. It's really easy to sign up. Check out the link underneath and you can make some extra income. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you two different methods. One of them is a little bit simpler than the other one, but they're both going to give you different results. But before I do, forgive me, I'm just going to touch on a little bit of color free. Don't worry. It's not going to be long and it's going to be painless, but this is going to be really useful. So what I'm doing is I'm in the Adobe Color Themes panel right now, and you can open that from the window menu. And what I just wanted to show you is a color wheel. It's really important that you understand this, and don't worry, I'm not going to get super in depth. But essentially what we're going to be doing is we're going to be using the complementary color. So that means there's two colors. So if you move this around, say for example, you know, we've got green on one side, we've got red on the other. Those are the Christmas colors. There's absolutely no coincidence there. What it is these colors will always work together. So you've seen this gold and blue kind of a look. And in fact, we're going to be using that for our cinematic color grading. It's very commonly used. And then you can see other ones. So if you want to know what color works with your color, just pop this open and see what's opposite of the color wheel. You can also create your own color wheel by looking at the rainbow. Red, orange, yellow, green, blue, violet, indigo. Those are the colors that go around in the rainbow and create that color wheel. All right, so now that we know we want to be using them on both sides, it's going to give us maximum impact. Let's look at a couple of different methods for doing it. The first one is we're going to take this and we're going to give it a little bit of a vintage color feel, and we're going to use the Camera Raw plugin. The next one we're going to use is curves, and you're going to love both of these. So let's go up here and we're going to go under filter and we're going to choose the Camera Raw filter. All right, so we're in here right now and you've got all these adjustments. The quick and easy way to do this is to actually just go down and use the split tone adjustment, which is right here. Now there are many other ways, and I'll do more tutorials in the future showing different ways of applying this color flavor. But the simplest way that we can start with is if we just want to add a little bit of color into the highlights and into the shadows. So when you look at cinematic, usually what happens is they add this orangey color, and I'm sure you've heard it. We have to add some saturation, by the way, see that? So you'll see some orange added into the highlights and then a teal blue in the shadows. So let's give a little saturation so we can see what's going on, and we'll move it into that teal blue and see how that's starting to give it a little bit of a cinematic flavor. However, there's a couple of things I want to show you. Let's go back to the basic adjustments here. By the way, if you're working in Lightroom, these sliders are exactly the same. Okay, so the next thing, you usually see that the saturation is pulled down. In fact, we can do it with the vibrance. Just drop that vibrance down a little bit and it gives it that desaturated filmic look. And, you know, depending on what style you're going for, you can leave it like this. And if we look at this before and after, you can see that. But the other thing that you'll see sometimes happens is they crush the blacks. So we can pull those blacks down a little bit and also push the contrast up a little bit. Now, if I hit the P key before and after, you can see that. Now, if you don't want to use vibrance, let me just reset it. You can also pull the saturation down just a little bit. See that? And maybe give it a boost of vibrance. And that can also give it a different flavor before and after. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to go back to that split tone. Now, I'm going to give it just a little bit more saturation so you can see a little clearer. And I just want to show you a couple more combinations. So this is one kind of error that you'll be kind of used to probably seeing in a lot. I call this the Blockbuster look, and I'm going to give a better example of that with curves. But one of the other things you can do too is you can give it more of, if we take this into the warmer colors, see, we're starting to create a different kind of a different feel there. See that? So we can kind of warm up our shadow and highlight colors there. So that's another combination. And then there's a third color combination I'm going to show, which I've seen used quite a lot. And that's a yellow in the highlights. And then a little bit more of a green in the shadows. Now, you can also play around with the saturation and make this a little bit more subtle. See that? And so this gives a kind of a different kind of a vintage look right there, and we can also play around with the balance. Now, if you want to save these as presets, just go into the preset here and then just click save, and we'll call this one vintage. And I'll give you a link, in fact, you know, I'll give you a couple of these presets. All right, so now that you've done that, that's one way of doing it. So we can just click OK, and we can apply that, and then we can see, if we go into our layers panel here, we can see our before and our after. See that? We just applied that. All right, so let's go in, and I'm going to show you a different method here. So what we're going to do in this method is, under the layers, we're just going to go in, and we're going to grab the curves adjustment. So make sure you apply this as an adjustment layer and click on curves right there. So here we are in curves, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start in the bottom and just drag that across a little bit just to kind of darken down our shadows. All right, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to choose our blues. So we're just going to click about the 3/4 area and just kind of increase that a little bit. See how we're putting those blues into the shadows right now? And if that's a little much, you can just kind of click up here and bring it back down a little to keep it from contaminating those highlight areas. Now let's go into the reds, and we want to do the opposite. This time we're going to click and increase it. So we can see we've got some reds there, but it's actually starting to turn purple here. So we want to kind of click in that 3/4 region and pull that back down, and maybe even reduce it below that average line there, which means that we're not going to have so much red there in our shadows. All right, the next thing we can do is we can go into our greens, and then with our greens, we can just kind of tweak this. We can increase it a little bit or decrease it to give it the flavor and the feel that you want. I'm kind of liking it about there. That's looking pretty nice. So let's have a look and see where we are before and after. There's the before, and there's the after. Of course, we can also add a hue saturation adjustment layer if you want. And we can just reduce the saturation just a little bit if you want to kind of give it that little bit more filmic look. Now, this is personal choice whether or not you're going to do that. All right, let's have a look here. And we can see we've got our before and then our after. Now, if you want, you can always double up on that. Just hit Control J. And if you feel like doubling it up is a little too much, you can always dial it down using opacity so you get to kind of mix in it where you want. So let's bring it up to like about 48%, looks pretty good. Now there's one last thing I really want to do. We're going to change this top one. We're going to change that to color. So now it's just affecting the color and not the tone. Of course, underneath here, if we change this to color, we're going to lose that darkening. So what we can do is we can just double click on here and we can just tweak it. Because if it looks like the face is just a little bit washed out, we can just pull that down a little bit with the curve. See that? And you can give it a little bit more dramatic shadow and bring back some of that detail. So these are all variations that you could do, and I definitely recommend that you experiment. So this is a before and after. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this. Just remember, it's just a springboard. There's so many different ways you can go with this. Feel free to experiment. Don't forget to use these complementary colors and do different things and kind of see what you can do with your photography. It can really open up whole new worlds to you by playing around with this color grading. So anyway, the photos that I'm using are all from Adobe Stock. So don't forget to check out Adobe Stock, guys. There's a lot of cool stuff there. So anyway, if you like these kind of tutorials, hit the subscribe button right now and you'll get a new tutorial every single week. Now add a comment. Let's get a discussion going. I'd love to see what you guys think about that. And also, what are your favorite recipes for color? I'd love to hear them. So anyway, guys, if you like it, pound that like button into dust. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.